I've only owned a couple of LEP before. The first was the Nextorch L10 Max, which was impressive even though it was in the value realm of the LEP world. I also had the chance to check out the Allied Valkyrie Turbo, which was a bit interesting though meant as a dedicated weapon mount light. The Fenix HT30R is the first handheld LEP that I've used from what I would consider to be a well-established flashlight company, by and large. I really like Fenix. My first real flashlight was a Fenix. I feel that Fenix puts out some very solid and quality products, so am I curious to see how a Fenix LEP can perform? You bet I am. Size-wise, I consider the HT30R to be very comfortable to hold and operate. I feel like 21,700 lights strike a nice, happy medium on sizes and overall sit in the hand pretty well even if they tend to be too big for EDC carry. The Fenix HT30R is long compared to your average LED-based flashlight. But this isn't, it's an LEP, and LEP lights tend to be much longer to house the advanced optoelectronics. In terms of carrying, the Fenix HT30R comes with a pocket clip pre-installed. The clip is very firmly attached and should work well, though I can't see pocket carrying the HT30R too often. Fenix included a lanyard that is a small step above your average flashlight lanyard. It is embossed with the Fenix logo, and it has an adjustable bead for cinching the lanyard down. Lastly, Fenix also threw in a fabric holster for this LEP. The holster seems to work well, and would probably be my preferred carry method if I wanted the HT30R with me free quality. In my experience, Fenix doesn't mess around. They used the typical A6006016 aluminum for the body, and then gave it a good coating of high-I anodizing. The finish is really well done. It's a bit on the shiny side. The battery tube is covered in grooves that form rings down its length. These provide a little bit of traction but not a ton. I would say that the Fenix HT30R doesn't just feel like a flashlight. It feels like I'm holding a professional tool when I have it in my hand. Part of that is because it is a professional-grade tool. It also speaks to Fenix's attention to detail and build quality. Everything seems really well executed. The HT30R takes 21,700 batteries. Or in a pinch, you can use 18,650s with Fenix's ALF18 battery holder. The light arrived with the Fenix ARB L21 5000 V2 5000mAh 21,700 battery inside of it, isolated with a little plastic protective disc. The included battery is a protected button-top cell. I tried a flat-top non-protected cell in it, a Molosil 42A. Despite the HT30R having springs at both ends, the Molosil was too short for the light to operate. The kit includes a USB-A to USB-C charging. In order to plug in the cable, you need to unscrew the neck of the light, almost like you're using a Zumi light. But instead of changing the focal length, unscrewing the neck reveals a USB-C port and an indicator LED, both of which are normally sealed off with an O-ring that becomes visible when you unscrew the neck. Side note, you cannot turn the light on with the neck unscrewed. Lux was measured by a UNITUT383BT at 10. Lumens were measured in a homemade lumen tube using a TSL2591 sensor, calibrated with a Mocha calibration light. The temperature was monitored with a MLX90614IR temperature sensor. The included Fenix battery was used for testing. I hope you found this video helpful. It's my pleasure if you are helped a little at least. If you have anything to query for, please comment us below. Thank you for watching this video.